And that's all. some point in time, we're going to be playing almost 2 hours. Pretty long show. We're going to play all some really esoteric old stuff for real. We haven't played in a few years. And somewhere along the way, we're going to play some of the new stuff off the new album that'll be out a week from today. It's been premiere on the United States on the Benny Little program last Wednesday. So we'd like to play some new stuff for you now. This is Burnin For You.
We'll be right back.
of unknown origin.
Down the hallway.
you two are meant to do. You know, it's kind of surprising.
Godzilla!
You guys ready? From our first album, Everybody knows we're into a lot of topical material about movies, a lot of different things. Just watching Channel 9 today, saw the Joan Crawford movie. She was living, all right, 1943, I think it was. Here's Joan Crawford from the new album.
Thank you. We'd like to play something for you from our Secret Treaties album.
When I'm home.
fall, a little bit of this and that. We're not leaving yet, you know? We got lots more stuff to play. Gonna play for you. Everybody here familiar with Heavy Metal magazine, perhaps? Yeah. Has a lot of this kind of stuff in it, you know what I mean? Well, they're putting out a full-length animated movie that'll be out, I guess, October, September, August, whatever, sometime soon. I don't know, whenever they release it. And this song from my new album is going to be in the soundtrack. It's called The Veteran of the Psychic Wars.
Don't let these things go on.
Everybody gotta quiet down a little bit during court bar at night here. You never know, to be in a rock club, be home listening on the radio, be anywhere. And all of a sudden, all the stuff you took in the 60s and 70s might come flashing back on you, you know? I mean, you can be sitting there all of a sudden, have a nice conversation with your friend, and all of a sudden, say, wait a second, shh, quiet. I think I hear something big coming this way now.
We'll be right back.
nice to know. When you tour all around the whole world, you still find the greatest audience on Long Island. Yes. Say, we travel just about everywhere. You know, afternoons get a little dull on the road, so you bring along cassettes and tapes and listen to the radio. You people don't know how lucky you are to have a WLIR to listen to. I mean, they don't play anything, you know? I mean... All right. We're trying to have a contest for the world's heaviest song. Here's our entry. We'll be right back. this one for your formations of fortune.
We'll be right back.
gotta give up, man. Give up your bed. We got you. We got you. We got you.
It's all, you know, sex, drugs, and rock and roll. Well, you know, sometimes maybe yes and sometimes maybe no, you know. I mean, there are sometimes when you're married, you're really lucky if you live at home, because then you wake up in the morning, somebody makes you a nice breakfast, makes you coffee, and puts real maple syrup on your pancakes and stuff like that. I mean, when you play rock and roll, you play like 1, 2 in the morning, get back to the hotel about 4 o'clock. And then you wake up at 1 in the afternoon, and there's, you know, you can't get up and you don't feel like having lunch when you just woke up. So if you're really well prepared like we are, you see, we got this down to a science, you see. About 4 o'clock in the morning, before you go to sleep, you walk on down the hall of the hotel. Right next to the elevator, usually, there's the ice machine. Go down there to the ice machine. You fill up the bucket all full of ice. And you walk back down to your room, and you put in the six-pack that you brought back from the gig from the night before, and you put it in the ice. Then when you wake up at by 1 in the afternoon, whatever it is, you wake up. You wake up in the morning. You don't sleep. But I woke up.